This video, connection drills. We're going to talk about little lead follow concepts that allow you to practice things at home with your partner or even on your own, so that we can get more efficient in our lead and follow concepts and to make dance much easier. So let's bring Kerry into the video.
The patty cake exercise or drill is one of my top favorite two connection drills, especially if you have just started dance or you need to polish off your connection skills.
Yeah, and we still introduce it into class every so many months because it's a great refresher.
Yeah.
So before we get moving, we also want to make sure that we're doing our correct footwork. So, and the visual concept behind dance is a really important part of what we do in couples dancing. So let's say that I naturally start on my left foot, which I do for the majority of dances.
As a leader and as a follow, I'm with my right foot.
Yeah. Free. Then what I'm going to do is step forward to Kerry on that left foot. She's going to step back on the right. Then I'm going to move with my right foot. Then I might choose to not continue to move in that direction. So I rock back. Kerry only rocks forward. I continue to walk and she follows. And it doesn't matter that she's a little bit behind what we're doing because it's lead follow, and that's how dance is supposed to work. So once we've done that drill up and down the floor a few times, we now know, well, that's my footwork. And you may need to do it if we just come a little bit closer and we pretend we're patty cake. I do some walks down the floor and I say, all right, I could get three in there without running Kerry into the wall. Notice we didn't pick up that other foot, my right, Kerry's left, because we're getting ready to go the other way. And then we walk it out and Kerry follows. And then I slow down, I rock, and I'm like, all right, I'm ready to go. And then I move and away we go. And so get used to doing that. And it's not going to be perfect because we're not touching. And it's okay that maybe sometimes we clip shoes or whatever, but you get used to moving with each other and get that visual. And then you know you have to be on the correct foot.
There's a couple tips that I want to give you. What you probably saw, whether we were further spaced apart or closer together, I did not stare at Shane's feet to pick up the movement. I actually stared at his body because his body language and his shift of weight are going to, I wasn't even looking at him. I just got him in my peripheral vision and we were working together that time. Because his body language, his intention of his shift of weight and his travel are going to be very apparent to me. I don't have to have my eyeballs glued on his feet. So that's one thing to take into consideration. Keep your heads up, good posture. And then the other thing that I really want to point out is the fact that neither Shane and I are completely lifting our foot off the floor. When we do that, we're asking ourselves to balance on one foot, which is making it harder than we need to. And it's taking away some of our grounding and our balance. So you've probably noticed that we were what we call tracing the floor. We are keeping connection with our foot with ever slight bit of pressure. And I feel like I think of having a tissue underneath my foot and I'm moving that tissue with me, which means I'm not digging into the ground and causing a lot of resistance, but I'm still staying connected enough to give myself more stability, balance, and grounding. So those are two things that will really help you whether you're touching or not touching.
All right, so now into the fun part. Well, the other part was fun because you can play around with that and have a bit of fun tricking each other. Not that that's really the whole
you
idea.
You are not trying to trick one another. No. You're trying to work together as a partnership, the nonverbal communication. Yes.
But it can make it fun if you're doing that. All right, so we want to go patty cake, patty cake. And we want to think that we're splitting the difference between our bodies so that we're not one out and one partially in, or not one in and the other one partially out. We want to be roughly the same distance apart from that center point.
The image that I use is there's a plate glass window between the two of you. You're going to keep the palms, entire finger and hand, connected to that plate glass window. Neither of you are going to try to peel away from the plate glass window, and neither of you are going to try to break through that plate glass window, so you stay equidistant with elbows slightly flexed on either side.
Yeah, if we just shuffle that around, so you can see we don't have our elbows locked in. We've got them off our body, because remember, this is a drill. This will be a great drill to practice connecting up in a ballroom style dance. All right, so we've got patty cake, patty cake. We pitch forward a little bit.
Our head and shoulders are over the balls of our feet.
Yeah, and I'm feeling like my knees are just soft. I'm not like flexing them back. All right, then what I do, I take a little step, and I don't know if you noticed, but to get Kerry to move, I was actually split weight, and I shifted fractionally to my right, so she'd release that right foot so I could step out on my left.
So we'll show that this direction.
So I'm standing like a typical guy with my legs open on both feet. I shifted. Now I can get Kerry to move side to side. That's the best way to get this going. And then as I transfer on my weight, I start to pitch more forward into Kerry. So when I move on that left to right foot, or I move and then stop, that little pause feels like Kerry knows where I'm going. You see that? And then I felt she went a little more, so I relaxed. I slowed my movement down. I allowed her to get that foot corrected.
So what we tend to say is use the length of your floor. And what we like to do is have the leaders start out in the leading role and the followers starting out in the follow role. I like to suggest that the followers close their eyes because then they're really interpreting the truth feeling and they're not letting their visual help out with the process.
Yeah, and you might have to build up to the trust, the confidence, just in yourself to close your eyes and
it's
then in your partner. And remember, these are meant to be fun games, so don't take them too serious. It's okay to get it wrong, because in reality, what makes dance so much fun, especially when we're talking social style dances like swing dances and country two-step and country swing, things like that, is that it's never going to be perfect. And we're not looking for it to be. That what it is I'm okay to adjust to help my partner out, lead or follow.
There's a higher sense of level of sensitivity and understanding. So we're going to demonstrate several of the different ways we can use the full entire length of the floor with the leader being in charge. So Shane's going to back up as far as he can, and because we have kind of a short little space to demonstrate for you.
And if we do it on a slight diagonal, we'll actually be able to go further.
Perfect. So Shane's going to just take me forward and back, no stopping. He's going to take me all the way to the wall, and he's going to take me all the way back. So the standard forward and back is an easy thing to do. And you notice that in keeping my feet to the floor, I'm trying to match his speed and his footstep length, rather than rush ahead or fall behind. We don't want him to feel like he's pushing a Mack truck, but we also don't want to pull our hands away from one another. And I think that's probably hardest when whoever's following is going forward. And I'll show that from the side. Because if Shane starts to back up, most of the follows tend to separate when they're first learning, whether it be the palms or their full hands. And really it's my job to keep pitch forward and keep my entire hand against that plate glass window like we talked about. So that's one thing, the forward and the back. The other thing is to pause while going forward and back. So if he's on his way forward, he's just gonna pause for a minute, whichever step that he likes, and then continue in the same direction. Same thing with going back. He can go back, pause at any point that he likes, and continue going back. And the goal there is during the pause that whoever is following is not getting crazy with the foot or agitated that they're staying in place. It's okay to be silent and collect if need be and wait for the next movement. So that's another thing that you can practice on the forward to back. Now, one of my favorite things to practice on the forward to back is the shifting of the weight without necessarily traveling. So Shane is gonna take me forward, and at some point in time, he's gonna rest me on the leg of his choice. So he takes me forward, he's gonna rest me on the leg of his choice. He's gonna shift the weight back and forward for him, or forward and back for me. And he's gonna try to control if he can move my weight, perhaps over my arches, perhaps over the ball of the forward foot for me, or back of the heel for him, or perhaps switch past the arches and into the next foot for me. So it's a nice little fun way to play. How sensitive can you be with the connection? And then he might decide to take off forward again, or if he stops and pauses, and does a little rocking step, he can choose to take off backward again. And that's making the follow really stay sensitive to what's going on. So those are several of the different things that you can practice forward and back along the floor. Once you do that, I like to ask that we switch roles. That whoever is normally the follow, take a chance to lead a little bit and get a taste of what that's like and what it entails and how difficult it is. And also whoever led first can flip-flop and start to follow. And when you do that and assume the other person's role that's not your normal role, it can really shoot your understanding of the connection sky high. So fun with that exercise.